Hey everyone, one of the tools that's included in OpenRollercoaster Tycoon 2 is the Tile Inspector. The Tile Inspector is an incredibly powerful tool and is very useful if you want to create nice looking things in ways that are normally not possible. In this video I will show you 10 things you can do with this tool, and I will shortly discuss each one of these. So let's move on to number 1. Number 1. Making things invisible. The Tile Inspector has a button which allows you to put a corrupt element on an object. If you do this, the object will become invisible. This is really useful if you want to let a ride travel on an invisible track, or if you want your guest to walk on an invisible path. I made a tutorial on how to make things invisible, so you may want to check that one out. Number 2. Changing the connected edges of a footpath. When you select a footpath in the Tile Inspector, you can change the edges of the footpath, which are connected to another footpath or a stall, for example. This is really useful if you want your guest to be able to access a stall, which would normally not be connected because of a wall in between them, for example. You can also use this to fill in little gaps you may find when you connect your double-wide path to a set of stairs. This is also a good way to manually tweak your queue lines. Number 3. Copying and pasting objects. Copying and pasting objects is probably what I use the Tile Inspector for most of the time. Especially when you use track elements as scenery, copying and pasting is incredibly useful, as you can reuse a track piece on the entire map. Sometimes I see people make 10 wooden roller coasters when they are trying to make a roof, for example, but it's much easier to just copy and paste a piece and continue building from those. Copying and pasting pieces is also incredibly useful for merging different roller coaster types. One of the Tile Inspector's greatest functions. 4. Rotating objects. This feature is very useful for track pieces that you have just copied and pasted. Is your track piece not in the correct orientation? Simply press the rotate button and it will be rotated 90 degrees. 5. Changing object height. With the Tile Inspector you can change the height of objects. I mostly use this to put track pieces on heights where you can normally not place them. By modifying the height of track pieces, you can put them in between heights where you would normally be able to place them. This allows for some great effects and is really useful when making track texture. This can also be used to great effect with scenery. Number 6. Deleting objects. If you place a track piece or other object where you didn't want it, you can delete it with the Tile Inspector very easily. This is very useful for entrances or exits you may have copied, or just to quickly delete something. Number 7. Changing object order. This is another very useful feature of the Tile Inspector. By modifying the order in which objects are shown in the list, you will modify the order in which they are drawn. If a wall is visible through a block, for example, you can change the order so the wall is no longer visible. You can also move objects on the surface to hide their supports, for example. Number 8. Sloped fences. Some fences and walls can be placed on a slope. With Tile Inspector, you can slope these pieces anywhere, even in mid-air. It's incredibly useful, since these sloped pieces are often used to make nice-looking buildings. Simply place down one of these fences that can be on a slope, select it in Tile Inspector, and select the way you want to slope it. Number 9. Move ride entrances and exits. If you want the entrances and exits of your ride to be in a different place, even a few tiles away from your station, Tile Inspector is your best friend. Simply copy and paste the entrance you want to move, press the Make Usable button, and remove the old exit. It's as simple as that. If you want to see more information on how to do this, I made a tutorial that should help you out. Number 10. Toggle chain lifts. In OpenRollercoaster Tycoon 2, you can put a chain lift on virtually any track piece. Of course, they will not be visible everywhere, but they can be very useful for boosts if you set them to a high speed. In Tile Inspector, you can simply select a track piece and toggle the chain lift checkmark. Now the track piece will act as a chain lift, and the trains will be accelerated to whatever speed you set the chain lifts to. Now, I know this video is called 10 things you can do with the Tile Inspector, but here's an 11th one. 11. Removing park fences. If you don't like the look of the standard park fences, you can easily hide them with the Tile Inspector. Simply select the tile with the fences and press the Hide Park Fences button. Now the fences will no longer be shown on this tile. Anyway, those were 11 things you can do with the Tile Inspector. That was probably not even all of the stuff you can do with the Tile Inspector. But this tool is incredibly useful for making nice looking things in OpenRollercoaster Tycoon 2. So if you have never used it, I can recommend you to get some practice with it. Myself, I can hardly play without it these days. Alright, that was it for this video. I hope you liked it, and I will see you again in the next one. See you later!